Who are you?
Richie.
Where's Max?
He's upstairs.
Get him.
Yes, sir. Bernie's waiting for you inside.
Wow, you look just like Benny. I know you're new. You just walked into a tense situation, and it's all going to be worked out because I'm going to work it out with Jason.
You've spoken with him?
Not yet. What's that?
Mr. Morgan asked me to give you these papers.
All right, I'll sign them.
Well, actually, sir, they've already been signed for you.
The shore accounts, casino profits, funds for the operations. It's all been moved?
Yes, sir.
All my business accounts were transferred and I wasn't notified?
That's right.
Okay. Where are the new accounts? Where did my money go?
Mr. Morgan has selected some very...
I didn't ask you about Mr. Morgan. I asked you where my money went. I didn't authorize any of these transfers. I want my money back now.
Sir, I'm afraid that's not possible.
It better be possible. It's my money. Profits from my businesses.
Sir, if I may pass along a message from Mr. Morgan, he asked me to inform you that he made these changes for your protection. He feels that your current domestic situation is affecting your ability to conduct business.
So Jason's taken everything from me. I'm sorry for losing my temper there. Your brother, may he rest in peace. He worked for me for a long time. He died trying to help me. His wife and kids are doing okay?
They appreciate the money. You were very generous, sir.
Your brother knew how things worked around here. He would have never gone along with Jason's unfortunate decision. He would have told me. It was his job to. I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt. But you need to understand that Jason is my employee. I depend on him. But he works for me just like you do.
Sir, I mean no disrespect, but now that the changes have been made, technically, I work for Jason. We all do.
Then what are you still doing in my house?
What are you doing here?
I live here. Come on.
I'm glad you came. I'm trying to leave you messages all over town. We're having pasta.
With meat sauce, our favorite.
You want to join us?
It's next week.
Mm-hmm. Now, before we start, I just want to make a toast. To friendship, it's carried us a long, long way.
Okay, this is great. Just us guys having dinner. Mom and Emily are great, but they get in the way sometimes.
Anybody want seconds?
Not me. I am stuffed.
Max.
Hey, boss.
You take the boys to Carly. Leticia will be there.
Yeah, sure. Come on, boys. Up and at them.
Hey, get out of the chair.
Come on.
Get out of the chair.
Yeah, there you go. I wanted the boys to have one last memory of how things used to be.
Now what?
Now you got what you wanted. You and I are enemies. Well, you were using your position of trust to betray me. I was actually making the decision to compromise with you, which is something that's not easy for me to do, as you know. It was Emily who convinced me that the compromise was the way to go. The same Emily, you are so determined to keep away from me, because that's what this is all about, isn't it? You want to punish me because I dared to fall in love with your sister, which is ironic. Since you fell in love with my sister, and I asked you to stay away, and you didn't.
No comparison.
Why? Why isn't there a comparison?
You barely knew Courtney.
She was still my sister.
Not one you'd watch grow up. Not a sister whose hand you held at what you thought was her deathbed, or try to find the words to comfort her when she'd been brutally raped. Emily is more than my adopted sister. And I'm not to stand by and watch her get hurt because she's with you.
I would never do anything to hurt Emily. You should understand that.
I understand
that.
You wouldn't want to, or you wouldn't mean to, Sonny. Let's get to the point. When you lose control, when you go through one of your things, when that happens, you go to a dark place and you try to hurt yourself or anyone who tries to stop you, and I'm not going to let Emily be that person.
You know what? I never thought I'd say this. But out of everybody that I know, right now you are being the biggest hypocrite. For as long as I've known you, you've lived by one single rule. The right to make your own decisions. You have fought hard against the people who try to control you. That's why you left the Quartermains. That's why you broke up with Robin. Well, Emily and I have the right to make our own decisions. I mean, you may not like it. That's fine. But you don't have the right to dictate what we do.
I am a hypocrite. And I may not be able to protect Emily from what's inside you, but I can lessen the outside threat. And I have made sure that you're no longer a target.
By stealing my business.
You can have it back. All you have to do is leave Emily alone.
I thought I made you smarter than this. Our business is not a trophy that you can just trade back and forth. You may have cleaned out my accounts, hidden my money, but I'm still in charge.
Just call someone. Give an order and see what happens. When was the last time you even stepped foot in a warehouse or dealt with a casino manager face to face? I'm the one who does that. The men are used to reporting to me because they've been doing it for years. The only thing that's changing is I'm not going to have to wait until you're able to focus again.
You're mad because I didn't let you kill Manny. That's what's going on here. You just want to throw away years of what we had, our friendship?
You threw it away. When you betrayed my trust and swore to give up Emily and you slept with her and then you lied to my face. Over and over, this whole situation is of your making, Sonny. And I'm doing what I've always done. I'm just cleaning up your mess.
You're not cleaning up anything. You're stealing. Let's be clear on that. You come into my house when I'm not home. You clean out my possessions, my money.
Like I said, you can have it all back if you leave Emily alone.
This is a business, not a football. You don't get to come in here, pick it up, bring it back 3 days later when I give you what you need. You're making us vulnerable.
You made us vulnerable. When you stopped paying attention. Trips to Spain, trips to the island, sleeping with my sister instead of taking care of business.
What did you expect me to do, Jason? You say I'm crazy, but you can't see what's right in front of your face. Emily's not a little girl anymore. She's a grown woman. She's been married twice. You're right. I shouldn't have lied. I hate that I did that. What I should have done... As soon as Emily got together, we should have just moved in. Is that what would have been better?
Moved in?
Well, isn't that what this is about? You think I'm dishonoring your sister? Maybe I should just marry her. Is that what
That is never.
Who died? Who died and put you in charge? God send the angels down
you,
here?
Sonny, you were going to hurt her.
You're going to hurt her! You're hurting her right now! Can't you see the pain in her face, the tears in her eyes?
I have done nothing since this started, but try to find a solution.
The solution
works for everyone.
To mind your own business. It's pointless, you know. I'm not gonna argue with you. You can't, you won't see or understand. So. What you need to do is you need to pick up the phone, give me back what you stole, and then get the hell out of my house.
You don't get it. You're not in charge anymore.
This is my business. I built it! Get out of my house!